Welcome to Sunday Outside, and let's read your comments from last Sunday. And it is user EJ3ZJ2CIAL, but I try the bird to see here. The Gary Thomas inquiry interview was good. He was an investigator and remembered a lot about his time there. He now realised that he was wrong in the mindset at the time and apologised for what happened to the SPMs and others. He left the post office in 2017, and there was the reason there's bullying from, and the reason was the bullying from John Scott. He caused another witness, Mike Wilcox, into a position where he had to leave, and he was effectively, constructively dismissed. I hope that awful person gets proper comeuppance. Nasty, horrible man. Hope the DPS computing gets sorted. Do you know what's going on there? I don't know the full ins and outs of what's happening there with the DPS computing. But the Gary Thomas interview. There's loads of interviews I can do videos on. I am trying to work on the better quality of the videos. Obviously, long-term subscribers know me better, that I don't have everything. I don't know how so many YouTubers seem to be able to have everything that just works and looks amazing. But I do try. This has gone off. I'm not using my usual one, as you can tell. This is Sherlock's. Thomas Rogers, but happy Easter, Charlie. Happy Easter to you too. Happy Easter to everybody. Happy chocolate egg eating day. And hot cross bun day. Although hot cross buns now have been practically been made all year round, haven't they? Red Pillars, but I thought just occurred to me. I reckon if Robert Rander, aka Judge Rander, or Rinder, whatever, was leading the inquiry, the press would be more keen on reporting it. Yeah, I think so too. Shane Ollis put, you're right, Charlie, worrying about my test results will not help. I have over 3 weeks to wait. Did you worry about the patronising doctor telling people not to eat a whole Easter egg? Who doesn't eat an whole Easter egg? Wouldn't it be wasteful not to? LJA857 has put, do it in a train voice. We would like to remind passengers that this station tests its fire alarm every Monday at 9 a.m. Thank you. I don't know what a train voice is. Because there's quite a few different train voices in stations, isn't they? Yorkshire Whiskers, but oh my god, your comments are getting hijacked into disarray, lol. Anyway, when you were mentioned you were working as a receptionist, it made me imagine you going in Linda in Gimme Gimme Gimme, where she is operating the switchboard. If you can't say no, don't bother to ring! So tempting to do that. Especially, do you have an extension number for her, please? And then, no, I can't. Mavis! Well, she's the office bike. And right, let's move on now to, it will be like the three inquiry videos that I did, where I just picked five random comments because there's just so many comments. I got an advert for a Jaguar car. A, I can't drive. B, if I could drive, I probably wouldn't be able to afford a Jaguar. And C, I live in London. Who can afford to have a Jaguar in London if you are illegal in some way? Oh, flipping heck. It's daft, isn't it? This is why I like Google tailoring adverts. I don't care if they know everything about me. At least give me some adverts I might actually be interested in. So, five random comments. Cherry Rotella has put, thanks for all your work, Sean, to bring this to us in a concise way. I think meant to put scene, but it's put the name Sean, spelt scene. Cam7522 has put, I haven't heard addressed the fact that ARQ data was not raw data. Pardon me? I just belched or spoke a comment. I'm so sorry. At 2158, I haven't ever heard address the fact that ARQ data was not raw data. It was manipulated by Fujitsu before it was delivered to the post office. Yes, I know that. There's certain things that need to be pressed more, I think. Mick Munn has put, thanks, Charlie. Your input and opinions are brilliant, so thanks. Let's be honest here. No one, absolutely no one, will ever forget the famous snakes, leopard and gold chain blouse. Oh, that Helen Rose top where I called it snakes on a chain. Oh, it was an awful top to wear. For a court as well. Contempt of court she was. Philanthropist Swell Foxy on us, but at least she appeared in court personally, absolutely. And another random one, feeling Thailand's new life with Ed. Thailand's new life with Ed, as put. I suspect that a lot of the legal professionals who chose to work for the post office did so because they wanted an easy life, accepted a lower salary, and frankly could just do just about do their jobs. It just seems like, apart from the horrible, nasty side of the post office and what they've done, it sounded like such an easy job to get paid an absolute load of money to do absolutely nothing, doesn't it? It sounded like a right breeze. You just breeze into work, do nothing what you were supposed to do, and get paid for it. But then it all went wrong because obviously then people's lives getting destroyed. Mate, already this tablet's annoying me. I need a new pill. One last comment from this one then was put. Oh yeah, by cops as put. I know there was a lot of M's, weren't they? Very annoying. Especially when you're editing it. And he's trying to, and it gets to a point where you've got to edit the M's out because there's just so many of them. Very frustrating. And right, we'll move on. We'll go straight into the Debbie Staple part two. What's the advert this time? A flight. I don't even have a passport. What is this? Go to Germany. I don't want to go to Germany. I don't have a passport anyway. I don't have a passport. I don't have a driving license. Who am I? Who am I? Nobody knows. Nobody knows. Anyway. Oh, the cat's back. I'm going to get a picture of the cat this time. I'm sure it's deaf. It didn't respond to cat, normal generic cat language. Anyway, let's get to Twin Rotors. It's bizarre when where these people paid to do nothing. Exactly, I know. User FI8YG2GQ2D has put, whilst she accepted that it was a stock take, she prosecuted on the basis of it being an audit. This is where I said in the videos as well that these audits that the post office was doing when they suspected somebody was stealing tens of thousands of pounds when there wasn't. It was a stupid Horizon system by Fujitsu. They were scamming people out of the money, the property, the job, the life. That's a complete scam. There wasn't audits. There were jumped up stock takes because there was using the Horizon system in the branch to decide what should be there and what was missing and this, that and the other. It was absolutely ridiculous. And William Evans has put, at least Miss Staple was had the decency to acknowledge the travesty of justice arising from the bugs at Horizon, and unlike a number of her former colleagues, others, her apologies to those affected. Today, although her competence might be questionable in some matters, at least she does not seem to be mendacious. Yes. I did actually feel she was being more genuine. She even admitted that she did wrong. But in the grand scheme of things, there's fatter fish to fry in this scam. And I really hope that those people are punished. Obviously, it's people like Jinal Singh and all the people at the top, such as Angela van den Burgaard and Paula Venels, which this week was only actually in concrete evidence that she did lie to that committee of people, to the court and to the government, that Paula Venels didn't know that Fujitsu could fidget with the figures. Yes. Last one on this. Continental Drift has put, £282,000 in 2007. Did anyone question whether it would possibly be based on a turnover of post office at the time? I had a look at post office for sale the other day, and that amount is more than some post offices have in turnover in 2023. Would anyone have questioned that amount if it was £1 million? Seems not. It is really weird, isn't it? Because even the judges in these cases must have figured out, hang on a minute, why are they stealing so much when it's allegedly easily traceable? And why would they steal so much? Why would they incriminate themselves ridiculously? There's no point trying to figure it out. As Judge Judy says, if something doesn't make sense, and it's probably not true. How many times do we hear that? Anyway, let's move on to part three. Where is it? Part three, there it is. And at first I thought staple was spelt wrong because I was thinking of a staple as in the stationery. But anyway, three random comments. Red Pillars put, bloody Nora, honestly, actually honestly. I love the term bloody Nora. It's like bloody Nora, Gordon Bennett. What's another one? I can't remember. Martin McDonald has put, can you recall? No, I cannot recall. Can you remember? No, I cannot remember. The post office investigator's main requirement for the job, amnesia. Absolutely. They can't remember anything. It's very annoying, isn't it? My skin's really dry again. I can feel it on my forehead. At least it's not flaking this time. Jude Westburner has put, why are they given a free pass every time they say they don't recall? I think a little more pushing could be made on certain things, because some of the things they don't recall don't make sense. Like when Helen Rose said, I can't recall of how she started an investigation at a post office. And but in that case, obviously, Jason Beer did say you did 1,400 of them. And then, obviously, then we got an answer. The default I can't recall is quite frustrating. Robert Overs has put, WTF, Jenkins has his own lawyer present all the time. Who's paying for her? Is she going to stop him answering questions? Why does he need her? This S would... should be top of the news, never mind the photo being altered. Absolutely. All that ridiculous story about the royal family photoshopping a picture. Thankfully, I didn't care, because why did anybody care? Who doesn't alter a picture slightly if something's a bit wrong? If I had swerkles right now and I had the ability to photoshop her on video, maybe use some sort of video editing thing to change the light so that I wouldn't have swirkles. I'm in a dark because it's lovely and cold today. I'd use it. It's normal. They probably would have done it back in the day with the old-fashioned box black and white cameras. I mean, you know, where the exposure took like about 2 years to take the picture. I mean, that's probably why there were so many blurred pictures, because people were readjusting themselves, this, that, and the other. They were technically photoshopping themselves. What is makeup? Makeup is photoshopping yourself in real life, isn't it? It's like when I slap on a bit of moisturiser to get rid of this bit of dry skin. I'm photoshopping myself in real life. It was ridiculous how people latched onto that story as if it was a huge thing. And then look how much it came back to bite them in the derriere, because it turned out to be some really sad news. Kevin Palmer's put, keep up the good work. Thank you very much. And Kathy Kate has put, prosecution may sharpen their memory. They should be arrested now. We've got actual proof that Paula Venables and Angela Vanden Bogart were perverting the course of justice. They were perverting justice. And they should now be arrested and bailed, and so should Janelle Singh, so they can't just like beggar off abroad and disappear, because they should have the passports taken away from them. And then they should be forced to physically appear in that chair in the courtroom. And it is the only time that I'd accept a video call link is if there was actually in a prison cell, because they deserve to be punished for what they did. Last comment on this one. Frank Riley has put, I think she does regret what happened. Someone replied to this one. Should we see what the reply was? The reply was from... Dismal Fist has put, I'm not entirely sure about that. However, I do see an individual with enough understanding of the process of law to realise how screwed up post office is going forward. The next tranche of this are the prosecutions, don't forget, where persistent and aggressive declarations of I don't recall happily, very happily, do not absolve the formerly untouchable managers and board managers of the evidence now in the public domain. She recently leaked conversations on the Channel 4 expose. Yeah, so there's been a bit of an uptick in the interest of the media, the mass media, on the post office story again, when they found out these recorded secret phone calls and the conference call. It is good that that happened. So it's nice to have a bit of input from the mass media for once, isn't it? Anyway, moving on. That's all the comments I'm going to do from the inquiry this time. And then obviously I'm doing another one next week. Let's move on to the next video. Yeah. I've got an advert for a Shark vacuum cleaner. I'm quite happy with my G-Tech, thank you very much. I've had it a few years now. I'm sure I got it like in 2020, somewhere about then. I think I did. Got a good deal from Lidl. Gusts of wind there. Is it strong enough to knock the camera over? No, it is not. It's probably affecting the sound. If it is, I'm sorry. Right, now something's gone wrong. Hang on. This tablet. Somehow I'd accidentally made it go to full screen. Right, comments. JLA8427 has put, when you stay in a hotel and the clocks go forward, they should let you check out at 1 p.m. instead of 12. Yeah, I can see where you're coming from, but that's never going to happen. Yeah, the clocks went forward, didn't they? So I've lost an hour this morning. And, which is just reminded me, I've got to get this done because I've got to get to work. Because it's bank holiday, obviously that's when they decide to do train works on the tracks. And it's so frustrating. Mick Munn has put, you can't beat Marks and Spencer's biscuits. Lol, happy Easter. Thank you very much. Them biscuits were just filthy. They were absolutely gorgeous. They're just so ridiculous over the top. And they're absolutely amazing. The only reason why you bought them is because I can't... Oh, I'll come in it now. I'll look in a minute. Chris Silver has put, this is madness. A chocolate-coated bourbon is just a penguin, though. No, it's not. They're completely different. With a penguin, the chocolate goes all the way around, but the middle buttercream bit goes all the way through. And they're made in such a way that you can use them like a straw to drink your cup of tea out of. You wouldn't have been able to do it with these bourbons that are melted too quick. Shane Ollis, but how delicious. Yorkshire Buskers, but Max and Spencer's biscuits. My God, you've changed, Charlie. I thought you were part of the egg and chips brigade like the rest of us. That 10,000 follower milestone has gone to your head. I can't believe I've got 10,000 subscribers. Thank you all so much. It's definitely not gone to me yet. It's blown my mind, I'll tell you that. What I'm eating UK is, but Charlie, Max and Spencer's now have extra cream custard creams and bourbons, and they are only 50p a pack, and each contains 12 biscuits, and they are both delicious. That would make a great follow-up video. What I'm eating UK yesterday, I already bought them and ate them. Well, I was with Sherlock, and we were in Westfield. And I thought, well, let's go and have a look in Marks and Spencer again and see what there is. And that's not a good, that's not a bad price what we paid for them. I think there was in like a multi-pack. And I think it was only something like £1.50 or something like that. And it was a full pack of the digestive, a full pack of the custard creams and bourbons with the extra filling inside of them. And then malted milk, which no one really cares about. Shock horror. I'm not really big on malted milk. They're nice, but on the full biscuit range that we have in this country, you know, they're pretty much middling, aren't they? The opinion put, at 44p a biscuit, Christine would approve. 6 in one packet, 1 for hair and 1 each for hair bagels. Little Hobnobs ran away. Little Hobnobs are really nice. Anna Parry has put, at school we had a project to design our own chocolate sweet. I did a 3-layer block of white milk and dark chocolate. Seems obvious, but back then no one had done it. About a year later, Thornton's added it to their collection, and I was so proud. Haha. P.S. The only biscuits I eat these days are Wagon Wheels. So tasty, but a nightmare to fit in your mug. Yeah, but I'm sure Wagon Wheels used to be bigger. But yeah, your chocolate thing. I think I remember it in the chocolate selection. That 3-layered different chocolate thing. Well done, you. We have that at primary school as well, design your own chocolate bar. They wouldn't do that these days, would they? It's, you know, because everything's all just PC work ridiculousness, isn't it? It'd have to be like, oh, I don't know, design your own fruit or something. You know, something dull like that. Design your own vegetable. Our teacher's pet when I was at primary school, Katie Medhurst, she was always into stuff like that. It's like, ooh, save the animals and this, that and the other. She was always watching Blue Peter. She was always coming in every Newsday. I can't remember what Newsday was, but I don't think it was every day at primary school. I think it was either like first lesson on a Friday, you know, something like that. And oh, she'd always be doing something like that. I'd bring in something hilarious, obviously. I remember bringing in a picture once, and it was out of, I can't remember if it was the News of the World or the Sunday Mirror, one of them pictures. It must have been a Monday then, because I remember it being a, yeah. Isn't it weird the stuff you could suddenly remember when you actually just go into details? Maybe the post office staff could do that. And anyway, it was of this bloke, and he was like morbidly obese. It was a double page spread. And he was complaining that he couldn't get around anywhere. And obviously these days, you would say, oh, that's so obesist, something like that. But it was awful, do you know what I mean? And it showed, it was full of all the usual lies. I only have 3 meals a day. Look, I've been fat, I've lost a little bit of weight recently, just accidentally, I've not been trying. But the fattest I've got, it was just slightly over 18 stone. And when you're that sort of weight, there are no meals a day. You just eat. You do. And I will say this because I think 18 stone is very much according to that ridiculous BMI thing, which we all know is rubbish because it never takes into account your build. There are no meals a day when you're that big. You just eat. So it's ridiculous for people who are like morbidly obese, like, you know, on that TV show in America, what is it, 600 pound whatever. 600 pounds spelt with elves. Why is it? It must be some Latin thing. Anyway, yes, there are no meals. And last comment, because there's like 4 comments from the same person. But before I get there, I've got more comment from ALVB7EW. But I love these biscuits too, but kind of felt the natural thing to have done would have been to dip the custard creams in white chocolate. May have made them way too sweet, I guess. Depending on the kind of white chocolate it is, Marks and Spencer's after all. That would have been nice. There should be a white chocolate version. And JLA8857 put, since you work Sundays, will Sunday outside be now Saturday outside? No. Let's get to the next video, which is the last full video. The next advert got was for a Ford. Now, if I did drive, I probably wouldn't get a Ford. Could I afford a Ford? Yes and no, but I probably wouldn't get a Ford. Because why? It's not 1980s or 1990s anymore. And anyway, let's get on to the comments. JLA857 spot. For April Fool's Day. I hate April Fool's Day. April Fool's Day and Valentine's Day are two of the most stupidest days of the year. Well, April Fool's Day is thankfully meant to be just the day, isn't it? But some people still carry it on for the entire day when it's just, no, it's just the morning. Anyway, on April Fool's Day this year, can you please cook something in the air fryer for Sherlock and then freeze it? Sherlock won't know what is going on. That's mean. Yeah, I could put an ice cream in the air fryer and be all serious. No, because it's not Friday, is it? It's a Monday this year, thankfully. Mick Munner's put, I love Toad and the Earl. Oh, yeah, by the way, it was the air fryer Friday Toad and the Earl. I love Toad and the Earl. Some veg and a few roasted potatoes are lovely. And I'm already 2 Fridays ahead with my Friday outside, with my air fryer Fridays. And that's good. I've also got 2 other videos backed up as well, so I'm going to be like 4 weeks ahead. And Steeler666 has put, can you set draw 1 and press sync end and it'll automatically do the time and temperature so you don't have to? Can you set draw 1 and press sync end and it'll automatically do the time and temperature so you don't have to? Yeah, when you turn it on and just press start, it'll do the presets it's already got. And the preset first one is the chicken leg thing, which is 180 degrees for 20 minutes. So you can just press start and it'll just cook, yes. Is that what you mean? Gavin Colborn has put, at 1 minute 18, it's always best to preheat air fryers for frozen food, just like with ovens. So around 200 degrees C, around 3 minutes is usually good. I've never had a problem really with it though. I mean, yeah, I've had to put a few things back in. But the time saved and the energy saved on not preheating a whole massive oven, I don't see that as much of an issue. So, I mean, yeah, obviously, great comment. But, I don't think preheating the air fryer is really going to be much. I mean, does it really make that much difference apart from heating the metal insides? Don't know. The premium's put, I noticed it's an air fryer this week. No mention of an air fryer. Very common of you. Aldi Microwave has run away. Yeah, no, sometimes I don't forget to say air fryer. It's like Microwave, isn't it? I sometimes still say just microwave. It depends on the edit. And Chris Silver has put, have you been watching the new series of Mandy on BBC iPlayer, Charlie? Think you'll like it. If I'm not on YouTube, I'm making videos for YouTube. And yes, it gets very difficult to watch anything else on different channels. Although I have been binge watching Keeping Up Appearances again just recently. The bouquet residence, the lady of the house speaking. Sheridan. The temptation to do that to Sherlock. If Sherlock ever rings me on his phone, I'm going to have to do it. Well, I mean, your kiss, but I don't know what has happened to Iceland. The quality has gone right back. The burgers that used to have three ingredients now have a full of fillet and the same price. They seem to be adding onions to everything too. Iceland, yes. I'm still annoyed with Iceland because when I went to Iceland in 2010 to 2013, 2012, somewhere about that, wasn't it? I did say to even the area manager and my managers, and even went to the head office in Deeside for Iceland, because it was when they were starting the internet shopping up again online. And I said, look, the freezers in the shops are really inefficient and they waste space and energy. Why don't you have something built in? It's going to save money and make more space. And I was ignored. I was told to shut up by my manager. Well, so there you go. That's that, really. Moving swiftly on. Yorkshire Bus Guys put, 7 minutes don't seem very long for Iceland fish fingers. Personally, I do them for 6 minutes on each side as I can't be done with the soggy and limp fish fingers. Yeah, mine was a bit soggy on the bottom, but for a sandwich, I like it to mush up a bit. I like them well done with a bit of crunch on the breadcrumbs. Absolutely, yes. That's a good point. I'd love like them more firmer all the way around if I'm having them with chips or beans or something like that. But I was putting them in wraps and the mushiness just helps squash it all down a bit. Lovely. Ooh, salivating already. And Mr. Bum. I don't think it's really a name I can really say on YouTubers. But hi, Charlie. Why don't you set up a GoFundMe page, i.e. buy me coffee, etc. Everyone does. Everyone doing it. If you had said this years ago, you and said, me, buy me a coffee, a pound, the subscribers would have given you £10,000 by now, just a thought. Well, Mr. Bum, I know I should, and I'm stupid for saying no, but nearly every YouTuber is doing it, where they're saying, pay me on Patreon and Ko-fi and here on YouTube and buy me a coffee and this, that, and this. Everyone's doing it. Everyone, it seems, except me. Because I still don't feel worthy of badgering you all for your money. Just watching me is amazing to me. So thank you very much. That's my reasoning behind it. Now, I know I might sound stupid for that. Lots of people are like, you're mad, you're stupid, you're silly. But it's just how I feel. Anyway, moving on now to the YouTube Shorts, which I've just suddenly remembered. I did flipping loads of them this week. I better get a move on. Me and Sherlock, or Sherlock and I, we went to Angel. And we just decided to have a nice meal out. Just got somewhere different. A meander, if you will. You did a meander and you didn't film it, Charlie. I know, Charlie, what you're going to do about that. Talking to myself. See, talking to yourself is normal. It's answering to yourself like I just did, which is worthy of you getting dragged away. In one of them jackets, but I'd ask not to because I don't like jackets. Yorkshire Bus Guys, oh, this is because there was a Waitrose, a heavy tulip, next to a Sainsbury's, a Sainsbox. But then I missed out that just slightly and opposite, there was a Marks and Spencer's food hall. So you're getting a kind of idea what the clientele in the area is like. Yorkshire Bus Guys, but a balcony above a heavy tulip. Oh yeah, there was a balcony above it, wasn't there? That'll be where they stand and look down on the working classes, no doubt. Red Pillar 6050 has put, more money, less sense. That would be Heavy Tulip's slogan and jingle. I know, but even Heavy Tulip's gone down market, though, hasn't it? The shops are mucky and the stocking of the food isn't that good. The advertising's gone a bit kaput. Sharon White has completely destroyed John Lewis and Waitrose. I mean, she's done such a terrible job. And she's still there. She's even announced that she's leaving. She's going to be her tenure is going to be the shortest in history of the company's entire history. Shane always put, Sainsbury's helps the middle class's anxiety in more common places. It is only used in an emergency situation. Absolutely. I think Sainsbury's going down market happened when they started opening all them Sainsbury's locals. And with really shoddy fitting out of the shops, just looks really tacky. Some of them look all right, but the vast majority of them just look really rough and ready. The Premium Pub, who was there first, Heavy Tulip or Sainsbury's? Christine would be appalled. Far too many Sainsbury's bags for life's near her. Lidl and Aldi ran away. Yeah, it won't be long to Lidl and Aldi are there. I bet there's one already there and I just missed it. The banger bus is coming. I hope you're wearing spats at the top hat. All right, just say, good day, sir. Yes, I also had a monocle. And what I'm eating your case, but Sainsbury's is anything but posh these days. They raced Aldi and Lidl to the bottom on price and quality. Absolutely, I agree with that. I was just fondly remembering at the time, I think, when Sainsbury's did used to be posh. Maybe it was just posh when I worked there and then I brought it down. No, I didn't. I did work for Sainsbury's for about 8 months, I think it was, in 2000. And yes, it was when it was posh and it was nice. You know, people used to cross the Humber Bridge to go to Sainsbury's. It was worth doing. The next time YouTube short video was when I got stuck on the London Overground. It lost power, which was fun. It was for me. Sherlock wasn't that impressed, but I was. The Premium Pub. Someone in the admin department hadn't paid the electric bill. Smart meters ran away. Yeah, I wonder if London Underground have a smart meter. That'd be hilarious, wouldn't it? It'd probably break like the rest of them. Do you remember me saying about that? I just don't get a smart meter. And even other YouTubers are saying just don't get a smart meter because it's dodgy. JLA857 has put lots of train announcements he wants me to say in a voice like a train, probably. And the opening calls for calling the Lidl helpline for some reason. Kate Southern has put, oh god, that's bad. It wasn't too bad in the end. We were stuck there for about maybe 10 minutes. Thankfully, I didn't need the toilet and I wasn't thirsty or hungry or anything like that, so that was fine. And everyone was quiet. There was no arguing, there was no, oh my god, what are we gonna do? You know, like if it was in America, I think that it'd be like uproar or something like that. Or Japan, they'd be like uproar as well, because they'd be calm but very cross because everything's to the button there, isn't it? But here we were just like, oh well, this happens. Let me get back to the next bit. Oh yeah, the next video, YouTube short, was where I just managed to catch one of the announcements in full. The Premium Pub, we are just downloading the payment app and subscribing, signing in, etc. We are also looking for a shop where we can charge our electric key. Steam trains ran away. I was really hoping that they'd send us down the embankment. I was expecting there'd be a big problem and we'd have to detrain onto the embankment. And on the embankment, somebody had fly tipped a bathroom suite. Flipping it, fly tippers. And then beyond that, there was like a fence. So I was thinking, I wonder what happened there. And the last YouTube short video was that awful vase that was in B&M. We went to Harrow on the Hill. And at Harrow on the Hill, there was a B&M. It was a massive B&M as well. I think it used to be a former Debenhams or House of Fraser. I forgot to look it up and check. And it was an awful vase of a disclothed woman. With the baps out and the fajita out, which is far too much to have. Let's see if is it gonna show you it? That. Look at that! Why would you want that in your house? I mean, if you're that way inclined, get a real person, you know, if you want to look at that. You don't get a vase of it. But yeah. Anyway, Mick Munn has put, what's Sherlock going to say if you brought this home? Yeah, Sherlock, I got this for your Easter. I would not have such an item in my house. No. The Premium Pub, Christine has already run away. Absolute tat. Is this what those at B&M think we are like? Tat. I'm sure JML wouldn't sell anything like this. QVC have copied Christine and run away. I would love, do you remember back in the day on that little magazine thing you used to get inside the News of the World? And it was like that magazine thing. It'd have the TV in for the week, and it'd have loads of other little news stories and bits and bobs on it. Usually something from what's her face. Oh, what's her bloody name now? She popped across the Mystic Meg. It'd have like her 7-day full couple of pages in Outlook for your star sign. And on the back page, there'd always be some ugly ornament. And they'd say it was hand-decorated by somebody and designed by somebody else. Now, how exquisite it was and how exceptional it was. And all the rest of the words thrown out of a thesaurus. And, it'd be some right bilge. And it'd be affordable on 4 easy payments of something or other. It'd be some awful tat. That is what it looked like, didn't it? Absolutely awful. And the last comment of that video, and of indeed today's Sunday Outside, is from JLA857, of course, who's put, "Hello, I'm a £7 budget Venus de Milo. Can you buy me from B&M? I'm getting a phone on Sunday, meaning I can watch Charlie Fleming talk about me on Sunday Outside." It's just an ugly, ugly ornament, isn't it? It's making me feel sick just looking at it. And why has it got £7 sticker on the bosom like that? And why are the protruding bits so exposed? You know what I mean? Says me. It's better. This white bit just makes it look worse, doesn't it? Does it? I don't know. What have I been doing with my life? Thanks for watching. Scrubs, let me know in the comment section down below. Anything about comments or something or whatever. And back in the day on Sunday Outside, I used to reply to all your comments, but I don't anymore. Not because I'm lazy. No, it's because I've been told off by the crow. Saying, yes, you are. I'm not. It's because there's so many comments, obviously, for the post office video. There's the crow. It had something in its beak. It found some food. It looked like a biscuit or something. What was it talking about? I've forgotten. I'm not lazy. I'm reading loads of comments, obviously. There's so many comments to the post office videos. And then if there's multiple comments and long comments, I can't read it out because it's just for fairness for everybody else. Anyway, thank you for watching, everyone. Scrubs, see you when I see you. Bye. I nearly stood on a plant pot earlier on. Let me just pick it up and show you for proof. Look, what was it a plant pot of? Lavender! I love lavender. Lavender. Dutch lavender. English. The snails of it!